Welcome to Good Shepherd Baptist Church streaming services. Catch us at goodshepherdbaptist.org or on our Facebook page every Sunday at 10 a.m. Also join us on Mondays at 6 p.m. and Wednesdays at 6:30 p.m. The days and times listed on your screen are also available on the website. In just a few moments, we will be joining Bishop Jeffrey L. Reeve, Sr., Senior Pastor of Good Shepherd Baptist Church, with today's message. We can be reached at goodshepherdbaptist.org. Follow us on social media on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Also, download the Good Shepherd app from the Apple iOS App Store, Google Play, or Amazon App Store. And giving online is easy. Go to goodshepherdbaptist.org and click the Give Online banner. Or, using the app, click the Give Online icon.
Good morning, Good Shepherd. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Help us have church this morning. Listen, Lord, I just want to thank you. Lord, I just want to thank you. Lord, I just want to thank you. I want to thank you for being so good to me. So good to me. Praise Steve. Heaven say, Lord, I thank you.
Lord, I just want to thank you.
Come on, let's talk to him, y'all.
Lord, I just want to thank you.
Lord, I just want to thank you.
Lord, I just
want to thank you. So good, so good, so good to me. So, say it again, Lord, I just want to thank you.
Lord, I just want to thank you.
That's what we woke up just to tell him.
Just
want to tell him thank you for one more day. Oh, Lord, I want to thank you. Lord, I just want to thank you.
Want to thank you
for being so good to me. So good to me. Help me say, Lord, I just want to bless you.
Lord, I just
bless your name, Jesus.
Lord, I just
come to bless your holy name.
Lord, I just
want to bless you. Lord, I just want to bless
Lord,
you.
I want to bless you
for being so good to me.
Woo!
And it praises, Lord, I just want to praise you.
Lord,
I just want to praise you.
Lord, I just want to praise you.
Cause you woke me up this morning.
Lord, I just want
to praise
you.
Didn't have to do it, but you did.
Lord,
I want to praise you.
For being
so good to me. So good. Lord, I just want to thank you, say.
Lord, I just want to thank you.
Lord, I just want to thank you. Thank you,
Lord,
I just want to thank you.
Lord, I just
want to
thank you.
I want to thank you
for being
so good. So good. Everybody help me say, so good.
You've been so good.
Say, so good. You've been so good. Woke me up this morning. Started me on my way. Didn't have to do it. So glad you did. Say so good.
So good.
So good.
So good.
So good.
You've been so good.
You've been so good.
You've been so good.
Had it been good to you? Has he ever brought you through? Has he ever made a way?
You've been so good.
You've been so good. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Want to tell you thank you. Want to tell you thank you. I've got so much to thank God for. How about you? How about you? Everybody clap your hands. Tell somebody I got a whole lot to thank God for. You ain't typing. You ain't saying it. Say I got a whole lot to thank God for. Has he really been good? Jesus, thank you. Thank you for my mother. Thank you for my father. Thank you for every sister. Thank you for all my
for being so good, so good.
If you got something to thank God for, take a moment and thank Him. Come on and bless Him. Give Him the glory. Give Him the honor. Give Him the praise. Somebody just shout hallelujah. Somebody shout thank you, Jesus. Because He's been so good to us. That's why we came here to praise Him. Bless the Lord, everybody. Woo!
Join us today after worship service at 11:30 a.m. for a Youth Ministry Moment with Pastor Angel White. Youth Ministry Moment takes place at 11:30 a.m. every fourth Sunday. Join us for this time of encouragement and empowerment.
The Shepherd staff, books, gifts, and music has the new word for you today. Stop by and get the new edition of this incredible devotional. The Shepherd Staff Books, Gifts, and Music is open Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. inside of Good Shepherd at 2223 South Crater Road in Petersburg. You may also call at 804-863-2665. That's 804-863-BOOK. The Shepherd Staff Books, Gifts, and Music with the new word for you today.
Food distribution at Good Shepherd Baptist Church is back. Good Shepherd is now partnering with Feed More, and again with Communities in School Petersburg and St. Stephen's Episcopal Church. The next Petersburg food distribution will be Wednesday, December 8th, from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. And once again, to make this a success, we need you. We need volunteers. Volunteers may sign up now at goodshepherdbaptist.org. Click the Petersburg Food Distribution banner and sign up online. Help us to be a blessing once again to the area. Volunteers are asked to arrive at 11 a.m. That's food distribution at Good Shepherd Baptist Church with our partners Feed More, Communities in School Petersburg, and St. Stephen's Episcopal Church. Wednesday, December 8th, from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. Tell a friend, and God bless you as we help feed those in need.
Hallelujah, God. We worship your great name, Jesus. We just want to show our gratitude to you today, God. You're so worthy of all the honor, all the glory, all the praise. Just take this time right now, Jesus, to bow before your throne. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. I thank you, God. You for You kept us here right now, Jesus.
And we're grateful, God. Hallelujah. We thank you, God. Hallelujah. Let's receive the word.
Blessed be the name of our God. We thank you for tuning in to our worship service this morning. We praise the Lord for this opportunity that we have to stand before you again and to tell you that there is a word from the Lord. I'm excited about this sermon series we've been in during the month of November. We'll make an attempt to close it out and so see if we cannot properly package the message into a whole. And most of all, we pray that God is pleased with what we have said and done. Come on, bow your heads together with me as we pray. Father, we thank you this morning for our time together in the Word. You have already blessed us, Lord, through the ministry of music. And we ask now, God, that you would allow your presence to linger in the room a little while longer. We pray, oh God, this morning that wherever we are, wherever we're watching this broadcast from, that your presence and power will be transmitted, transported into each and every space. Oh God, may we feel and sense and know that you are near us in this hour. Please now, oh God, I pray that you would manage my mind and amplify my voice. Set my soul ablaze with the Holy Spirit is my prayer. And I ask it now in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And thank God. Again, I want to invite your attention this morning to the book of Revelation, chapter 4. And we're going to look at the final clause of verse 1. The final clause of the first verse of Revelation chapter 4 from the New Living Translation of the Bible says, "The voice said, 'Come up here, and I will show you what must happen after this.'" Amen. The voice said, "Come up here, and I will show you what must happen after this." For a few moments this morning, I want to talk to all of us about a penthouse view. A penthouse view. John said that the voice spoke to him and said, "Come up here and I will show you what must happen after this." After this, he said. After a period of painful isolation out on the island of Patmos. After this, God wants John to know that his life still has purpose after this, that beyond the current state of chaos and confusion that is going on in his life, God wants John to know that God still has a plan. In order to receive this revelatory information from God, John would have to activate his imagination, because all of the images that he sees are indications of what is and what is to come. The relevant question for you and I this morning is, then what will happen after this? What is it that God wants John to see? What is it that God wants John to know? And we know that in order for him to see it, in order for him to know it, as we spoke in an earlier message, he has to reposition himself. He has to leave where he is, and he has to endeavor to go where God is. And when he gets to where God is, God says, let me show you something that you didn't know. I need to show you what you can't see. John, I know that you are moving from the beginning to the end, but I am the God that knows the end from the beginning. And I want to show you what will happen after this. What will happen after this? Well, first of all, I want to suggest this morning that whatever happens, it cannot be contained, corralled, or changed. Notice the language of the text this morning. The Bible says that John said that the voice that spoke to him said, let me show you what will happen. There is an air of absolute certainty coming from the voice that spoke to John, suggesting that what will happen after this, that it cannot be altered. Amen. It cannot be changed. It will not be contained or corralled. It will happen. And I need to tell somebody this morning who's in that place where you have resigned yourself to life as you know it. You don't think that anything can change. You feel as if there's no more for you. You have reached the end of your rope. You have reached, as it were, amen, the final stop and destination of your life. In fact, some of you have become so saddened and depressed, you don't even feel like going forward. You can't even muster up the energy to try again because you don't feel like anything significant and meaningful can happen after this. But I got to tell you, child of God, there is something after this. And whatever it is, all I can tell you is, amen, it cannot be contained, corralled, and changed. It will absolutely, positively happen. Secondly, I want to suggest to you this morning very, very quickly that whatever happens, it will be post-predicament. It will be post-problem. It will be post-pain, and it will be post-pandemic, reminding us, child of God, that our current situation is not permanent. Let me say that once and ever again and tell you that whatever happens after this, come on, it's going to be post-amen predicament, post-problem, post-pain, and post-pandemic. Amen. I'm telling you, child of God, what you need to know and what you need to be encouraged by this morning, amen, is that there is something coming after, come on, your current state of affairs. And please know that it cannot happen until after this. You got to go through this where you are, what's happening to you right now, amen. But I'm telling you, on the heel, amen, of what you're dealing with right now, there is the next thing that will happen according to the voice of the Lord, which reminds us again, child of God, that our situation is not permanent. And I need someone to understand that because, amen, while we're here on earth, we can get into spaces, amen, where we think again that nothing is going to change. But I want to tell you, amen, that all of the earthly realm, amen, is transitory. Amen. As a matter of fact, when compared to heaven, not only is the earthly realm transitory, amen, but it also can be called trash. It's the kind of thing, child of God, that will one day pass away. As a matter of fact, the Bible reminds us, amen, that heaven and earth shall pass away. Amen. But the word of the Lord, amen, shall remain and it will not fail. The word of the Lord is, child of God, that there is more coming after this. In the natural realm, come on, we need, amen, to be focusing on the spiritual realm. Because in the spiritual realm, we get exposed to eternity. Amen. We get exposed, child of God, amen, to the reason that you and I were created. I tell people all the time that I may be, amen, in a physical body, but I am an eternal creature. You are as well. You, amen, were built for, amen. And if you live right, you are bound for, amen, eternity with God. And I got to tell you, child of God, you need to be encouraged this morning, amen, but and hear the voice of the Lord reminding you that your situation is not permanent. Amen. Your trouble is not going to last always. That's how we used to say it in the language of our faith. And somebody needs to hear this. Come on. Yo, listen, the weeping, amen, that you are experiencing tonight, amen, come on. It may last throughout the night, but the good news is that joy comes in the morning. Can I tell you, child of God, amen, that all of the difficulties of this moment, amen, are going to dissipate and give way, amen, to a brand new sense of delight, amen, that's brought into the lives of the children of God, amen. Those who have listened, amen, to the voice that told them, come here, amen, I need to show you from this realm another reality to help you deal with the one that you're currently going through. So whatever happens, it can't be changed. Whatever happened, it's post-predicament, post-problem. Come on, post-pain, and I'm just doing this for contemporary reasons, post-pandemic. But lastly, I need to tell you that whatever happens, come on, God's going to get the glory, God's going to get the honor, and God is going to get the praise. I know I've spent, amen, the better part of the month in Revelation chapter 4 and verse 1, but I really encourage you, amen, to read the whole of chapter 4. Go on chapter 5 if you feel like. 6 and 7 wouldn't hurt either. And I'm telling you what you will find out, that what God shows John, come on, while he is out on the island of Patmos, amen, and yet simultaneously in the presence of the Lord. I wish I had a witness here. He shows John that at the end of the day and that after all of this, that God is going to get the glory, God is going to get the honor, and God is going to get the praise. Now, I need to park right here because there are so many people who struggle with this, because it seems that what I've just said to you, the fact that God's going to get all the glory, the honor, and the praise, amen, it seems a little empty to you because you wanted something out of this. Amen. After everything you've been through, come on, you're the one, after all, that's out like John out on your island of Patmos. It's you, after all, amen, that's had to endure this enormous burden, and you've had to experience, come on, this excruciating pain. You was hoping that after this, you was going to get something out of the deal. But can I tell you, child of God, what you have to remember is that in the midst of all of this, amen, you in the presence of God. And can I tell you that in the presence of God, there is the fullness of joy. And at his right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. The fact that I suggest to you and state emphatically that God is going to get all the glory. God is going to get all the honor. God's going to get all the praise. Can I tell you, it may be empty to you, amen, but it is as it should be. God should always get all the glory and get all the honor and get all of the praise. Can I tell you, child of God, that's what worship is all about. This whole revelation, as it were, that John is receiving out on the island of Patmos is because, amen, he is in a place and in a posture of worship. And it is while he is worshiping God, come on, he sees these images that illuminates his mind. Come on, he gets a revelation that rejuvenates his spirit. And he's able to see at the end of the day that what he's going through personally, amen, what the church is going to go through, come on, amen, corporately, he understands that it's not affected, I wish I had a witness here, by what's going on in eternity. Amen. At the end of the day, come on, there's still one who is sitting on the throne. There is one who is wielding absolute power. There is one, child of God, who is calm, cool, and collected. There is still one, I wish I had a witness here, who is orchestrating and maintaining and supervising, amen, overseeing everything that is going on in the earth. And at the end of the day, he's going to make all of it work together, not only for our good, amen, but also for the glory of his name. That's why I told you a moment ago that it's kind of empty to some people, because they expect the only ones to get something out the deal. I mean, after the battle's been fought, come on, and the victory's been won, amen, you know how it is. We sometimes selfishly want to get everything out of the deal. But I got to tell you, child of God, amen, it ain't fair for you and I to get it all and God get none. I tell people all the time, and you've heard me say this, amen, I don't even want the blessing of victory if God can't get the glory. And I'm telling you, child of God, amen, whatever happens, amen, I don't know how things are necessarily going to turn out for each one of us individually, amen, but I do know, child of God, amen, that it will result in God getting the glory, the honor, and the praise. Let me just park here for a second and I'll let you go. But can I tell you, child of God, that when John is having this moment out on the island of Patmos, when he's getting these revelations, when he is seeing these visions, amen, when he gets these images, amen, can I tell you, reminding him, amen, that his life is not over, it's not going to end out here in Patmos, amen, that God says, I still have a purpose and a plan for your life. We know historically, amen, that even though John was exiled, amen, out on the island of Patmos, amen, he didn't stay there for the rest of his life. Amen. I know, amen, that when we look in the Bible, we know that 1 John, 2 John, and 3 John are recorded just prior to the book of Revelation. That's because the Bible, amen, has been canonized. Amen. And all of the books of the Bible are not necessarily written, amen, in the order that they are placed, amen, in the Bible. The truth of the matter is, child of God, amen, that John wrote 1 John, 2 John, and 3 John after his experience out on the island of Patmos. This is what I'm trying to tell you, child of God. God is trying to let somebody know this morning that your life is not over. You're going to come through this, amen, and what I have planned and purposed for your life is going to come to pass. I'm telling you, it can't be contained, corralled, and or changed, amen. You're going to have a testimony, amen, where you'll be able to tell others that where the Lord has me now, amen, he brought me through something else just to get me here. I'm standing this morning on the other side of through. And I'm telling you that when God brings you through, I know, amen, you want to claim all of the victory, and I ain't mad at you. All I'm telling you is that if you got the victory, please know that you didn't get the victory by yourself. Amen. You got the victory, child of God, by the strong arm of God. And if God's strong arm has gotten you the victory, amen, you better go ahead on and give God the glory, give God all of the honor, and give God all of the praise. I told you a moment ago that you need to go over and read the rest of the Revelation chapter 4. Amen. We see one of the major themes of the book of Revelation. Amen. Just a couple of verses down. John said that what the Lord showed him was a throne. I talked about this last week, but let me just say a little more about it. And can I tell you, child of God, that throne, amen, where the Lord is present, come on, it denotes, amen, again, the Lord's power. And he said, that's what I saw. He said, I saw, amen, one who was seated on the throne. And I want to tell you, child of God, he saw, come on, in the midst of what he was going through, amen, he was able to hold on to the promise of God about what was happening after, amen, his situation, amen, because the voice that spoke to him was coming from one who was seated on the throne. Can I tell you that he would not have been able to see that, amen, had not the Lord told him to come on up here, amen, and let me show you things that must happen after this. What the Lord does is, in fact, he gives John a penthouse view. Oh, that's my prayer as I close this morning. Lord, give me a penthouse view. I know some of y'all are wondering what that is. Well, I don't know what it is for you. I grew up in New York. Amen. I never forget, I had a little girlfriend. She lived in the projects, and she lived with her family on the 17th floor of a building that was 21 stories high. And from her living room and from her apartment, when I would go to visit her 17 stories up, I can look out of her window in the Bronx and see all the way in the Queens. I'm trying to help somebody and tell you that there is, amen, a panoramic view, amen, that is being presented to the people of God, those who are willing to worship God, amen, those who are willing to remain in touch with God, those who will not allow themselves to be separated from God by the situations that you are going through. God says, come on, amen, I want to show you something, amen. And what I want to show you has always been, you just couldn't see it from where you were. Oh, God, I'm going to try one more time. Lord, give me, please, a penthouse view. May I suggest to you, child of God, amen, that a penthouse view, amen, enables us to see down here from up there. I said a penthouse view allows us to see down here from up there. I think that's why so many people are struggling. I think that may be why so many people are fearful. Amen. They're only able to see down here from down here. But I cannot tell you that when the Lord, amen, elevates you, amen, in worship, when the Lord transports you and takes you, I wish I had a witness here, amen, from the place where you are and allows you to experience life from where he is. Learn to see the world from his perspective. Help you to look at life through his lenses. I'm telling you, child of God, you get a brand new perspective about things. And I got to tell you, while I'm at it, this really ain't a part of my sermon. Amen. But sometimes, amen, listen, when the Lord show you something, enables you to see down here from up there, sometimes it's just good. Just go ahead on and praise God for the revelation. Amen. That's bringing strength to your life. Because if you start talking about what the Lord is showing you about down here from up there, folk that are down here will think you crazy because they can't see it. But I got to tell you, child of God, there is a realm and there is a reality. There is a revelation, amen, that in this hour the saints of God have got to have. I wish somebody would talk to me like in the Old Testament, we need men and even women of God. Come on. Amen. Like the sons of Issachar, who have a sense of what's going on around us. And can I tell you, child of God, of all you operate in is in the physical realm, you're going to miss out, amen, on the revelation of God. My prayer as I close this morning is, Lord, give us a penthouse view. And may I add, as I say this morning, that what I'm asking the Lord to give us, amen, is really, amen, how can I say it? It's really incorrect for me to ask it. Because if I understand scripture correctly, what I'm asking the Lord to give us, he's already given us. Let me try one more time. I'm asking, Lord, give me a penthouse view. May I suggest to you, amen, but the Bible has already taught us, amen, in Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 6, that God has raised us up with Christ and he has seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus. Amen. May I suggest to you that what I'm asking the Lord for, he has already provided. I'm asking the Lord to give us a penthouse view. Amen. When in fact, the Bible says that in Christ Jesus, you already have it. Not only are you, come on, have you been transported, amen, to the heavenly realm, but the Bible says that we are seated in the heavenly realm with Christ Jesus. Can I tell you, child of God, amen, that the same power that raised Jesus is going to be able to raise us up also. And the good news is, child of God, though we know eventually and eternally, amen, we are going to be in the presence of God. May I suggest to you, amen, that this must become, amen, your current experience. Amen. Because, amen, it's got to be experiential. Amen. Because your very existence depends on it. And so, child of God, that which is eventual and eternal, revival has got to be experiential and existential for us. And what I'm trying to tell you, child of God, is that you're not going to be able to make it in this next season without having a penthouse view. You're not going to be able, amen, to have your finger on the pulse, amen, of what God is doing. Yes, if you're not operating in the spirit. I wish I had a witness here. The time has come, and now is, that worshipers must worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. I got to help somebody here. I believe, child of God, this is no offense to anybody, amen, but I feel a pushing in the spirit, amen, to say to someone as a way of encouragement, amen, that when you come back, you're not gonna come back the way you left, amen, you left as a member of the church, but you're gonna come back as a worshiper. I wish I had a witness here. We're living in some difficult time. We're living in a time, amen, where the heart of humanity has grown hard. We're living in a time, yes, when authorities are stubborn and resistant against, amen, God and faith. And those of us who are walking in relationship with God, we see what's going on around us. We see forms and manifestations of evil. It looks like the devil is having a field day, and he's getting the upper hand on the people of God. I thank God that God said to John while on the island of Patmos, he said, come on up here. Yes, I want to show you something that's got to happen after this. And I thank God that John, being the worshiper that he was, amen, he was willing to readjust. He was willing to reposition himself to get to where the Lord was, so that he could see what the Lord was trying to show him. That's what I want to encourage you to do. I want to encourage you to make worshiping God your lifestyle. I want to encourage you, not just because of the problem that you're dealing with, but because you know that God is worthy. Amen. That you'll wake up in the morning, yes, as you experience the brand new mercy of God, and that you lift your hands and you'll open your mouth and you begin to praise and honor God and thank God has given you health and life and breath and strength. Begin to honor the Lord. Yes, Lord, I'm talking about throwing your arms around the Lord's neck. I'm talking about you whispering sweet nothings into his ear. I'm talking about you kissing the Lord on his face. I'm talking about you loving up on God and worshiping God. I wish I had a witness of spending time intentionally developing your relationship with God. I'm telling you right now that if you do that, there will be a revelation of God that God's going to give to you, that's going to put you at a place of advantage when the rest of the world, yes, is caught up in the cycle of cynicism, and they're saying that there's nothing that can be done. I wish I had a witness here. You'll be able to lift up your head and tell, yes, the nations, lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory, he shall come in. God, I wish I had somebody. Can I tell you, child of God, you and I are going to have to take the journey. You and I are going to have to make the movement. Amen. God is not coming off the throne. You're going to have to come up to where God is. Have I got a witness? If you want this revelation, if you want this confident assurance, if you want a knowing down in your spirit,
in worship. You're going to have to allow yourself to be elevated up there where God is. And God will show you what's going to happen after all of this. God, I feel like I want to preach a little longer, but I better cut it off right here. And let's just tell you one more time after this. Come on, somebody, top it in the comments. Say after this. Come on, tell the devil that God is supervising my chest and he's put a time limit on what it is you're trying to do to me. It ain't gonna be like this always. I wish I had a witness here. There's more in store. I'm living in expectation because I know there's more that's coming after this. And when it does, have I got a witness? I'm going to join in with those who are already spending their time in eternity. Amen. Crying, holy is the Lord God Almighty. I wish I had a witness here. Come on, read it. It's right there in Revelation chapter 4. They were crying, holy, holy to the Lord God Almighty. That phrase, Lord God Almighty, was meant to denote, amen, the unyielding authority and the absolute power of God. And can I tell you that whenever it looks like the devil has power, please know that there is a revelation of God that is tailored to teach you that God always has more power than the enemy has. Y'all ain't gonna help me. And can I tell you that I'm gonna take whatever crown it is that I think I have. I'm gonna take it off my head. I'm gonna lay it down at his feet. I'm gonna join in with the host of heaven, and I'm gonna give God the praise. Come on, find you somebody and say, neighbor, after everything that you've been through, you, oh God, one more praise. Y'all don't help me. I said he done brought you through this. God has brought you through that. And after all you've been through, I said you owe the Lord one more praise. Come on, we're getting out of here. I said, but can you give God, I said, one more praise after everything you've been through? Amen. Some of y'all, amen, have had to wrestle, amen, with COVID-19. There are lingering effects that still remain in your body. Amen. But God, he brought you through to tell you that there's more after this. There are others of you, 20 months ago, you went into this season not knowing what was next, but since you've been in it and worshiping God, he's told you that there's more that's coming after this. Why don't you open your mouth one more good time right there in your living room while you're riding in your car and say, God, I thank you for the after that's coming in my life. God, I thank you for what's on the horizon. Lord, I bless your name. Amen. For all that is next in my life, I thank you that this was necessary in order to bring me to what you have next. Lord, I give you the glory. Lord, I give you the honor. Lord, I give you the praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The enemy wants to push you into a place where you stop trying, where you feel as if there's no more to be done. But I'm telling you that what's coming after this, the devil can't stop it. Are you hearing me? I'm telling you, he's gonna act like he can, but he can't stop it. He can't corral it. He can't change it. It will happen. Ooh, I feel the Holy Ghost. I said it will happen. Thank you, Jesus. I said it will happen. It will happen. The promises of God are yes and amen in Christ Jesus. Listen to me. You're already seated in heavenly realms through Christ Jesus. The problem may be you just don't know that you are. I believe that we would ascribe, we would ascend, we would endeavor to be who we are if we just knew who we were. There's a seat for you. Hallelujah. Because of Jesus Christ, there's a seat for you, reserved for you in heavenly places. And from that perched place, you'll be able to see down here from up there. Oh, glory to God. Listen to me. It's hard for flesh and blood to inherit the kingdom of God. It is hard for people who are not in the spirit to receive, let alone understand, the things of the kingdom. You are going to have to come up higher. What does that mean for me, Bishop? In a practical sense, how do I do that? How do I ascend? How do I climb? How do I get to where the Lord is? You can't watch television all the time. You can't stay on your phone, on the internet, on your computer all the time. You can't spend all your time there. Because that's the only revelation you're going to have. You can't give all your time to what the world is saying, watching what the world is doing. You're going to have to make it your business to spend time with God. Hallelujah. God will show you what must happen after this. When you hear pundits on television, radio, throughout the media, the best thing they can do is prognosticate. But God can speak a prophetic word into your life, give you a revelation that will surely come to pass. And until it does, you'll have a sense of assurance and certainty that everything's going to be all right. Did I tell you a moment ago that when the Lord gives you his revelation, you might want to just give God the glory and keep it to yourself? Because if you tell the people, they're not going to understand. The best you can possibly do is do what John did here in the book of Revelation as he tries to describe the images that he saw. We know that all prophetic revelation is hard to understand. And sometimes at the end of the day, the best you're going to be able to do is to tell your neighbor, based on the prophetic revelation I received, God's ability that enabled me to see down here from up here, I got a feeling that everything is going to be all right. You ain't going to be able to explain it to them. They're going to make you think you're crazy. And that you just have a feeling and it's not based on anything concrete. Don't worry about that. Just go to bed tonight knowing that the Lord said it shall happen after this. Father, we bless your name this morning and we thank you now for what will happen after this. Thank you, Lord, for, as we mentioned on last Sunday, thank you for the announcement. Thank you, Lord,
for the announcement that has now begun to build within us anticipation, while simultaneously sounding the alarm to the enemy that you ain't gonna never win. You're never going to stop God's people, and you're never going to keep God from getting all the glory, honor, and praise that belongs to him. Oh, God, we bless you. We bless you this morning, Lord, and we thank you again that it is not over. Our predicament is not permanent. Glory to God. We're just passing through here, and you have more in store for your children. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, we thank you for that soul that is listening this morning, and they want to have that kind of relationship with you, one that is spiritual, one that is filled and fraught with revelation. We pray, oh God, that they will submit their lives to you right now. They will seek from you first the salvation through your son Jesus, which alone is sufficient for the saving them of their sins, from their sins. Lord, pull them up out of that horrible pit this morning. Set their feet on a firm foundation. Put a new song in their mouth. Hallelujah is our prayer. Lord, save them for all eternity. Pray for that soul, oh God, who is hearing the Holy Spirit speak to them and say to them that they need to be connected to a good shepherd in a way that is closer. We pray, Lord, that as the promptings come up on the screen, that they'll be moved by the Spirit, oh Lord, to reach out and connect so that we can reach back out, so that they can walk in obedience to your will for their life. Thank you, Lord, for every member, every partner, every friend of this congregation. We pray, Lord, all pastoral blessings upon them in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, Lord, we pray, keep us all bound together in cords of love and of the Holy Ghost. Even while we're physically separated one from another, Lord, may we be one in the Spirit is our prayer. Keep us, oh God. Keep us safe. Keep us saved. Keep us sane. Keep us strong in this hour. And we thank you, Lord, in advance for the revelation of God that enables us to see down here from up there, reminding us that there's more after this that will happen. And now unto him who brought again our Lord Jesus from the dead, unto him be glory and honor and majesty and power, both now and forever is our prayer. It's in Jesus' name we ask it all. Amen and thank God. God bless you guys. Please stay tuned. Don't turn away. Amen. Our praise team is coming back. They're closing us out in worship. Amen. Let's turn up with them this morning and let's continue to praise the Lord.
All of you that got something to thank God for, I need you to rise to your feet and let's praise God together as we thank him for doing it all for us. Oh, so he did it all. All for me. He did it all way back on Calvary. That why I believe in divine destiny. God responsive. Verse 2 says, he did it all. That's why I thank him in advance. Why others start to complain, I still have my days. God responds. And he gives me
all I need.
He did it all for me. I want to say that second one again. Can I do it? He did it all. And I thank him in advance. Why others around me complain, I still got my name. God responds. And he gives me
all my needs.
He did it all.
He did it all.
He did it all. One more time, he did it
for me.
Everybody clap your hands. If you got something to thank God for, put it on the screen. Share with the saints and let them know what he done for you. Turn again. You ought to be thankful. Look with all your life. See where he brought you from. You ought to tell God thank you. You ought to tell God thank you. Say thank you, Lord. For all you've done. Say it again. Say thank you, Lord. Thanksgiving. I say every day is a day of Thanksgiving. Why? Because God's been good. Yes, he has. That's why we praise him. Hallelujah. We'll see you next week, Good Shepherd. Keep on thanking him. Keep on giving him glory. You don't have to wait for no special holiday to tell him thank you. You can lift your hands and tell him thank you right now. He's worthy. Yes, he is. Glory. Hallelujah. All right, we'll see you next week. Love you in Jesus' name.
Thank you for joining us today for Good Shepherd Services. Giving online is easy. Go to goodshepherdbaptist.org and click the Give Online banner, or using the app, click the Give Online icon. Follow us on social media on Facebook at Good Shepherd Baptist, Twitter and Instagram at Good Shepherd BC. And the Good Shepherd app is yet another great tool to keep connected. Download the Good Shepherd app from the Apple iOS App Store, Google Play, or Amazon App Store. We air every Sunday on Fox Richmond at 7:30 a.m. Please watch and support the broadcast. Good Shepherd Baptist Church, 2223 South Crater Road in Petersburg, Virginia. You may call at 804-732-5969. Building a church, developing a community, expanding services, and impacting lives. We thank you for the support of this ministry. See you next time.